So in today's video, it's about shaping synth sounds with noise samples or drum loops. So stay tuned. The lobe, an attenuate module to change the volume. This is how it sounds. So pretty default, pretty simple. And the second track here, there's some random noise sample on it, a vinyl crackling sound I downloaded somewhere on the internet. You can use what you want, but this is how it sounds. So nice little random noise and some crackling on top. And we actually just mute this so we can't hear anything. And we go back to the grid here. And now we need to drag in the sound or grab the sound from the second track. So we get a sidechain module here. And we choose as an input the second track and the pre-fader. So now when we hit play here, you can see we have a level there. And because we muted or we just used the slider to mute the second track, we only have a level here at the pre-fader because that's pre-fader. And we grab the audio there. And we can now use this to modulate stuff inside the grid. And for instance, we can drag this here into the phase signal. And we can use this there. But the actual noise is so fast at audio rate, basically, that you don't hear anything besides that you have just two sounds playing in parallel, right? So we need to do something about it. And what you can do is you can use an envelope follower. Use the sound here and basically track the envelope, the amplitude envelope of the second track of the noise sample. And now we can use this here to dial in certain parameters. For instance, we can use the attenuate. So when we have this at zero here, there's no sound. And when we use the envelope follower to raise the volume, basically, the noise sample decides when the volume is raised. So you can hear the noise is now influencing pretty much everything, for the at least for the amplitude. Can also use here to dial in the phase modulation, or the fault, or the skew. Or maybe even the pitch. Or the detuning of the two oscillators here for the left and right channel. The noise is static and predictable. So every time you are on the same frame or the same position in your track, the noise is exactly the same. So it's predictable and you can influence the noise at will. So for instance, you can go in here and choose a repitch for the sample and maybe make it slower or pitch it down, basically. So you get the more like a lo-fi feel. Maybe use some reverb. Okay. Okay, so you can use this basically to bring in a lot of movement, a lot of small little rhythmic elements to a pad sound. And as you can see here, you can use the modulation handle of the follower for basically everything, for the amplitude, for the pitch, for some of the settings here. Maybe you add a lot of more operators here and yeah, mix them together, and then you can modulate a lot of different stuff and bring in a lot of movement. What you also can do is, of course, you can use some kind of filtering here. Maybe use an yeah, a band pass in front here of the follower. So you can use yeah, basically multiple frequency bands for different modulations. So you can go in here and yeah, have basically different signals. Maybe use some of the lower bands for the usual stuff here, and some of the upper bands you can change the pitch or something like this. So there's a lot of stuff you can try out here. That's just an example. And of course, you can modify the noise sample also like you want. So for instance, you can go for a drum loop. Let's search something here. We have 1 out of 10. Go for this, maybe. Something like this. I don't know. Slice 120, and oh, 122. Okay, so let's try this. Maybe use a volume slider here in front of the. So now I have some kind of gate effect. Which can be interesting. But you can hear the sine wave is now exactly the same time active when here a drum hits occur. And that's, of course, what we want. But sometimes you want to fill in the gaps, and then can maybe you go for a long delay and use it in front of the follower, so we can delay the signal a bit, so we have basically a trigger signal in between the drum hits. Okay. So you can basically influence everything you want to get, yeah, some kind of gate signal or modulation signal out of noise sounds, drum sounds, or even another pad sound if you want. So not only the noise sample decides how to influence the sound in tonality, you also have a rhythmic influence. So it doesn't matter when you press the keys. It's always perfectly in sync when you use the follower here for the attenuate or for the volume to decide when to raise the volume. So you're always in sync with the beat or with the noise sample you are using, right? And this gives you a lot of possibilities. So when I remove the delay here again, and let's play here. So I can press any time I want. Because of the noise sample here, it's always in sync. So now we can use in front of the pulley grid here an arpeggiator basically, and dial in here some funny timing signatures, for instance, here milliseconds, which is completely off the grid, right? can even use a random modulator here to change the timing of the arpeggiator, and it doesn't matter because it's always in sync, because the noise sample decides when to raise the volume. So when I blend in here the drum loop, so it's basically perfect for influencing sounds, to just use your drum loop you're using in your current project to drag it into the pulley grid and use it for all kinds of modulations. So another option would be to convert this audio signal here, in this case our drum loop, into a gate signal and use that gate signal to trigger other drums or other synth sounds. So basically just convert it to gate signal and use that gate signal. So we have our drum loop here still running, and we go back here to the grid and I removed all the unnecessary modules here. We still have the audio sidechain and the sine and ADSR and an output, and we now use the amplitude here to go into a gain so we can change the volume, which is always nice to have. And I show you how this looks like on a graph. So I'm using here some oscilloscope so you can see what's going on, okay? So go this to slow. So you can see we have our drum loop here flowing in from the sidechain. And then we use a follower again. And then I use an oscilloscope again so you can see what's going on. So you can see all the small details are now smoothed out. So we have a much more simpler output, as you can see. And then we're going into maybe a gate length device, which looks like this. And then we go back into an oscilloscope and go to slow. Okay, so now you can see we have no signal here, okay? That's because we only get a gate signal when the signal is at 1, or I think at least above 50% or above 0.5. So we raise the volume here, and when we reach the 0.5 line here, you can see we have a trigger signal now, okay? And this trigger signal only knows two states, and this is 0 and 1. So we can use basically now the gain here, the volume module, as some kind of threshold. So when we go above the 0.5 line, then we have a gate signal. Everything below is no signal, as you can see, okay? And this way you can use it as some kind of threshold. But now we have here a gate signal, and that's the signal we can use for the for the envelope, for instance. So this way you can extract a groove maybe from some obscure drum loop or some noise samples you sampled, maybe a ping pong ball or something like this, or some exponential rhythms you are trying to use in your songs. So you can sample this and extract the groove via this audio sidechain, a follower, and maybe a gate length module to extract actually the gate signals, right? So to wrap this video up, I want to give you some examples at the end. So I'm using here two pulley grid patches. The first one is basically our trigger example here. I use the delay to just offset the trigger signals. And I'm generating a gate signal, and I'm using this to trigger this envelope here, which then modulates the sine oscillator, and it produces some kind of bass, and this is how it sounds. And And also the bass sound itself is modulated here. As you can see, I'm using the phase input here of the oscillator. So I'm shaping a bit the sine oscillator, or phase shaping, or phase distorting the sine oscillator with the drum loop a little bit, so I get some nice texture on top of the sine wave. So you can hear the drum loop shining through a little bit, okay? And then the second track here is basically just some chords. So it's our simple example here where I'm using the follower for the sidechain. And the follower here decides how to modulate the skew, the fold, and the attenuate, or the volume, basically, the amplitude. So then in front of the Polycrit, I'm using an arpeggiator here with the unusual timing, so milliseconds. And the attenuate, or the follower, decides basically to synchronize the amplitude with the drum loop. So this is how it sounds. Inside the clip here, I have just a chord, so I'm choosing the notes I want to play, but the rhythm and the color and so on is decided by the noise signal or the drum loop. So we can, of course, then switch chords and play different melodies on top, right? So at the end here, I have a ping pong ball example where I just downloaded some random ping pong ball sound from a YouTube video, and this is how it sounds. Okay, so it's... So that's it for this video. I hope you learned something new, and I showed you a new possible way of creating sounds, shaping sounds with drum loops and noise samples. And yeah, if you liked the video, then please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Think about the subscription over on Patreon, it helps me a lot. And I see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, and bye.